Mr. Spade. Mr. Spade?
Hotel reception desk, Beth speaking. What can I do for you on this very fine day?
Beth, I need your help.
Sophie? What's going on?
I think Mr. Spade's stalking me while I work.
Really? I knew it!
You did?
I mean, I knew there was something fishy about him. He just has creep written all over his face, you know? How did you find out?
He took pictures of me. I found them hanging over the bathtub. He set up a kind of dark room.
Pictures of you? Doing what?
I can't believe I'm about to say this, but sometimes when I clean the rooms, I get a little curious and, you know, snoop through our guest stuff.
Mr. Spade caught you in the act, I suppose?
Yes. I think we should call the police.
No, that's a terrible idea.
But
Sophie, that man has pictures of you running your hands through people's stuff.
But I didn't steal anything. I was just snooping, I swear.
I know, but say a client reports something missing. Those pictures would put a big red target on your back.
But shouldn't I warn someone? What if that man's dangerous?
Trust me, stalkers often bark more than they bite.
You've been stalked before?
I'm pretty sure it's part of the female experience to have at least one insufferable encounter with a creep.
I mean, I don't think it's ever happened to me before.
Well, I guess you're part of the club now. Unfortunately, being a creep isn't a crime in the eyes of the law, so you'd best keep it on the down low. And keep your eyes open.
Well, I didn't look through the entire room, but there is a safe here.
I bet that's where the good stuff is.
Do you have the safe combination then? I'm pretty sure it's locked.
Give me a minute. Those idiots.
What?
I can't find the combination list. The night staff's probably lost it again. Anyway, we always ask that clients write down their code somewhere so they don't have to call reception a dozen times. Maybe you can have a look around the room, and I call you if Mr. Creep comes back. You know, so you can get out of there in time.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, it's nothing.
Oh, and Beth?
Mm-hmm.
Please keep this between us.
Of course.
Locked. There has to be a key somewhere. Reception gave him a code. Maybe he wrote it down. Somewhere. Beaver Lake. I took Mom skating there just a few weeks ago. These look like numbers. Sort of. I just visited the oratory for the first time in years. This has to be a coincidence, right? Harry's diner, too. Were we ever there at the same time? X marks the spot, but there's no way this is just a treasure hunt. Is this a floor of the Clarington? Why did you check in under Mr. Spade? Something tells me you won't be missing this. We're request to move to 507. Why did you want to change rooms? I'd forget my own head if I didn't write everything down. I guess we have that in common. Letter from Bernard. Was there anything on the back? Request to move to 507. Why did you want to change rooms? Could that be a reminder for the safe combination? Could that be a reminder for the safe combination? If I'm lucky, the key to that suitcase will be around here somewhere. The storm must be getting worse. I hope Mom's not- request to move to 507. Why did you want to change rooms? Could that be a reminder for the safe combination? rough. How are you supposed to support yourself when no one will give you a job or a place to live? Pawning off your possessions? What do you need the money for? This was the sale where I found that winter jacket that Mom loves. Were you there too? Did you intend for me to discover your little dark room? Or did this just fall down? Sophie. Damn it. Come on, Sophie. Damn it. What do we have here? You spent 10 years in a psychiatric hospital. And it looks like you left with a long list of diagnoses and prescriptions. Oh, on, Sophie. Damn it. Come on, Sophie. I think I can put together the code now. Let's try the safe.